David Rosenberg, the chief economist at Gluskin Sheff, joins us today. And Dave, I want to ask you about some of the comments that Lakshman Akshithan at ECRI made with us last week. And he basically told our audience that when we look at the U.S., we've been in a growth slowdown for close to 2 years. There's really no sign of an imminent recession. We could see that in 2017. However, he said, you know, there's a chance we might just see a cyclical upturn in the U.S. economy. I think that's something that a lot of people don't expect. That we're, you know, already fairly late now in the business cycle. Perhaps this has been a long bull market by historical standards. Where would you put yourself in some of the data that you look at and the trends that you see at play between those two scenarios? Perhaps an earlier recession as early as 2017, or maybe even a possible cyclical upturn?
There's nothing in the tea leaves telling me that the recession is imminent, but I would say that growth is so weak that, you know, if we were to get some sort of a shock, you know, either a big negative shock from abroad, say that we get a hard Brexit that has a big impact on that other 20% chunk of global GDP called Europe, that filters through into a negative U.S. export performance, or say that the fragility beneath those GDP numbers in China reveal that things there are slowing down more precipitously, and there's a connect-the-dots impact through the emerging market world, again, back into the U.S. export scene, or say that the Fed makes a policy mistake and doesn't just hike rates once but a few times, and that proves to be a little too much to bear. The reality is that we don't have an economy right now with a big growth cushion like we've had in the past, where you've had 2.5%, 3.5% growth. We have an underlying trend in the economy right now that's basically, call it 1 to 1.5%. So I would say that there are fragilities and there is vulnerabilities. And so I don't really see that we have to have a recession, but we don't have a whole lot of cushion in case something bad happens. The case for a cyclical upturn, I would be fascinated to sit in the classroom and hear the teacher explain to me where the cyclical upturn is going to come from, where it hasn't come from already. You know, this is not a situation like it was in 2010, when we're coming out of the abyss and we can have a springboard on growth and we have the Fed easing policy aggressively and fiscal stimulus. We don't have fiscal stimulus, not yet, despite all the rhetoric coming out of the presidential candidates. I don't expect a conservative Republican-led House is going to be turning on the spending spigots. I think that's pie in the sky view. And the Fed isn't easing monetary policy anymore, right? If anything, at the margin, it's tweaking in the other direction. So if someone can convince me that we have something in terms of a positive exogenous shock that's going to cause this so-called cyclical upturn, I actually put lower odds of that happening than the prospect that we actually go into a downturn. So I actually think that the balance of risks are in the other direction. I don't see the case for a cyclical upturn unless something dramatic happens in terms of some massive stimulative policy shift that I see highly unlikely in the next couple of years.
Dave, do you think that the uncertainty over what's going on with this contentious political presidential election here in the U.S., do you think that that plays into sentiment much and what we see with the lack of business investment? Do you think that that's going to have much of an impact depending on which way that vote swings?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.